Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Catherine Clayton. This week, space station crew members completed yet another spacewalk and prepared to say goodbye to the Cygnus spacecraft. Last weekend, astronaut Andrew Morgan and European Space Agency astronaut Luca Parmitano completed the fourth and final spacewalk to repair the Alpha Magnetic Spectrometer, or AMS. It took just over 6 hours to finish the complex repair work to the 8-year-old AMS. In the days following the spacewalk, payload controllers turned on the new cooling pumps and are in the process of resuming science operations on the complex experiment, which means the AMS will be back to work soon, searching for evidence of dark matter and antimatter that give us insight into the origins of the universe. This was the seventh spacewalk for Andrew Morgan, and Luca Parmitano now holds the European record for cumulative spacewalking time, logging 33 hours and 9 minutes over the course of 7 spacewalks. The Expedition 61 crew turned their attention to packing Northrop Grumman's Cygnus resupply for release. Cygnus was packed with trash and discarded hardware to prepare for its release on Friday. The resupply ship arrived in November and carried over 8,200 pounds of science and cargo to the station. Cygnus will demonstrate a new release position for departure operations and will incorporate the first ground control release. This week's question comes from Darren, who wants to know what power source powers and maneuvers the space station. The ISS boasts 4 sets of solar arrays that convert solar energy to electricity. The station's solar arrays are attached to the station's truss and rotate to face the sun to maximize sunlight exposure. The solar arrays generate 84 to 120 kilowatts of electricity, or roughly enough to power 40 homes. While the solar arrays produce more than enough electricity to charge the station's batteries and provide energy for systems investigations, this energy is not used to physically maneuver ISS. In order to maintain an average altitude of 400 kilometers relative to the Earth, the ISS relies on the engines of the Russian Zvezda module or visiting vehicles to provide the force necessary to adjust its position. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag AskNASA, and we'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.